this one is, the figure shows the molding boxes we are going to use for preparing a mold. And in this molding box, there are the different varieties are available as shown in the figures. This one is a snap flask, which consists of both top and bottom flasks differently. And this one is a box flask, where one end is we can fix it with the help of some rivets and other screws. Next one is a slick. It is a small double-ended tool having a flat at one end and a spoon at the other end. It is used for repairing and finishing off small surfaces of the mold. So this one shows in the corresponding figures. Next one is a strike of bar. It is made of wood to level the surface of the rammed surface. Sprue pin. It is a tapered peg, and this one is bellows and mallet. And the sprue pin. The bellows is used in order to blow a small grain, small sand particles over the surface of the finished mold cavity. Another one, the sprue pin. It is a rounded bar which is used for production of this mold cavities. The gaggers. The gaggers can create. The gaggers is just like the shaped as shown in the figure. And this one is also the clamps. We are one of the instrument used for production of the molds. The brush is used for cleaning of the mold cavity after preparing of the complete mold. When the pattern is removed, some molding sand will be withdrawn. So in that case, we want to clean it. So we will use the brush. The smoother. The smoother is a softening plate which is used for smoothening the top surface of the mold patterns. Next one is riddle. Riddle is used just like a sheave. It is also named as a sheave, which is used for removing any unwanted impurities present in the sand. Next one is vent rod. It is used to make series of small holes to permit gases to escape. So this vent rod is as shown in the figure. This is a vent rod which can, after preparing a complete mold cavity, besides and in around the surface of the mold cavity, we will place some holes with the help of vent rod. Next, draw spike. The draw spike is a pointed steel rod with a loop at one end. It is used to wrap and draw patterns from the sand. Next one is wrapping plate. A wrapping plate or lifting plate is as shown in the figure, which is used to facilitate wrapping and lifting the pattern from the mold. Next one is gate knife. This is used for cutting gates before the mold actually prepared, before pouring the molten metal. Gaggers. These are also called lifters. These are iron rods bent at one end or both ends. These are used for reinforcement of the sand. Next one is clamps. These are used for holding together the cope and drag of the completed mold to prevent the cope from floating or rising when the metal is introduced into the mold. The cleaners and the sleekers are also the one of the tools used in the preparation of the molds for cleaning and other removing of the small sand in the mold cavity. This figure shows the trowel which is used for finishing of the prepared mold. Next one is molding board and the wrapper. The molding board is a flat board which is used for keeping the flasks over that molding board. The water sprinkler is used for pouring of the water, so adding of some water content to the molding sand. Now this one is a spirit level. The spirit level is in the figure is used by the molder to ensure that his bed of the sand molding box or molding machine table is horizontal. Next one is, what is the need of the cores? The cores provided the means of producing hollow castings. The next one is external and undercut features. Some intricate shapes are also developed with the help of providing cores, such as drainage fittings, hollow pipes, hollow shafts, etc. There are the different types of cores we are going to use for production of the other components. The first one is the condition of the material we will consider. Depending upon the condition of material, they are classified as a green sand cores and dry sand cores. In the green sand cores, the sand we are using, it is a natural available sand, and we will mix with water and we will form the cores. And in the dry sand cores, after preparing the core, we will add, that is, we will heat it to temperatures like 200 to 300 degrees centigrade. So that is named as a dry sand cores. Next, depending upon the native of the material, for a production of a good quality cores, we must add some bonding materials such as resin bonded cores, oil bonded cores, sodium silicate cores, and shell cores. Next, thirdly, the process employed for manufacturing of the cores are CO2 process, fluid or collapsible process, hot box process, and cold set process. So this one is the cores, position of the cores. The first figure explains the balanced core, and the second one is hanging and cover core. So this balanced core, it will be utilized for production of components, and then the core will be placed between the cope and drag. Whereas in the case of hogging and cover will be placed only either in the cope or either in the drag. Next, for preparation of the mold, there are the different molding machines are also